Well, welcome everyone. I hope you can all hear me and see me properly. My name is Jaime Arroyo, and today I wanted to talk to you about the new OCA document management system that is being developed. First of all, a little bit of introduction about me. I'm a software developer working with Odoo already for 2 years in the healthcare sector at Creu Blanca. I'm a very active member of the OCA since the day I began working with Odoo. I've especially worked in the human resources repository and the maintenance, but I also try to contribute to as much repositories as I can. And well, this is my username on GitHub, okay, in case you have seen me there. I guess we all know what a document management system is, and well, the name is pretty self-explanatory, but I think that giving a very brief introduction and remembering what it is can't be bad. A DMS is basically a system that we use to receive, track, and manage and store our documents. And given the large amount of data and files that companies usually have to deal with, having a software-based DMS and structuring properly your data can give multiple benefits to your organization. Between these benefits, first of all, we can find the most obvious one, probably. If you store all your information in a computer system, you don't have to store it in paper. So you can reduce the physical storage space you are using in your office, and you can use it for something more productive. It is obviously very difficult to go 100% paperless, but I am pretty sure that you can reduce the percentage of papers and documentation you have by using a nice software-based DMS. Another key point is the security. This is critical for all organizations, and having your most sensitive data protected is vital for everyone. With a DMS, you can have better control about who can access the information, who can modify it, and you can even have an audit trail that keeps track of all the actions that have been made in order to, well, to try to investigate what has happened in case that some problem occurs. Another of the main advantages is the search facilities. Having your data in a structured way can help you, can make the task of finding the document you're looking for much easier than looking in a bunch of boxes full of papers, which at the end of the day makes you save a very big and appreciated amount of time. So a positive point there. And finally, very, very important point too, is that it enhances the collaboration in your team. Having all the information in the same place and accessible by multiple people at the same time from multiple places helps you improve your communication and make your workflow more visible to everyone, which will result in a more agile process management. After this introduction, I wanted to talk to you about how can we manage our documents with Odoo, and how did we got this need in my company. Every day we are giving more. Our Odoo database is growing, and our Odoo instance is growing, but not only in data, also in the importance we are giving to it. Users every day are getting more used to the system and feel more comfortable putting all the documentation there related to invoices, employee documentation, and all of this kind of stuff. The attachments is a really good tool, but it gets to a point where it makes it hard to manage a large amount of data. So in some certain cases, records with maybe 20 or 30 attachments were difficult to handle. We also realized that with the importance we were giving every day to Odoo, and the more information we were adding to the system, to the ERP, we were splitting information between the ERP and another separated DMS system we are using, which at the end could lead to confusion or some problem. Then after that, we started looking for a solution. At first we thought maybe a connector connecting the two systems would be a good solution. We also checked Odoo, what did they have to say in this aspect, and they have a DMS in their enterprise edition, but we use we are using the community version and only use open source modules, so it wasn't an option for us. And then all of a sudden, almost as if it was made on purpose, this new option came into our path, the OCA. So how did all the relation between OCA and the DMS began? It all began with the company Muk IT, which, by the way, in the talk description, I said they were German, and I think they are from Austria. So sorry for that. They already had an implementation of a really good Odoo DMS in their local. They had it open sourced in their company repository, and luckily they after some discussion they agreed to move it to the OCA. This was perfect for us, and during the Spanish OCA days, this migration was done. Because as we all know, the DMS was really good, but the OCA has some guidelines to follow. So there are a lot of model renames and a lot of effort to do to make this transition and make their project be part of the OCA in what I think is a win-win situation. Since the OCA gets a really good DMS to work with, and Muk IT gets more people involved in the project, which will result in a better product for everyone. So that is basically how the creation of the OCA DMS repository was made. During the Spanish day, it was done, and the first pull request was created during those days a couple of months ago in July. I think it was in July. So what is the current state of this repository? No, the base module of the DMS is already merged in version 12 and version 13, and this module includes the base models, which are the file model, the directory model, storage model, all the views related to it. It also includes all the security related to the DMS, the access, the read, write access, permissions. It now recently adds the portal. I put in parentheses the pull request, but I think it's already merged for 12. In 13, it's still a pull request, I believe. Which, so having a portal also gives us a very nice another view option to manage our documents. And the last point, very very important, it also includes migration scripts from the Muk IT DMS to the new refactored OCA DMS. So in case that you already knew this project and you were using it with the Muk IT version, you can safely migrate it to the new OCA module. This is the part that it's already merged, but very interesting pull requests are open. Since we are integrating our DMS in Odoo, we want to link all these files to records. This is done with a module named DMS field, which is currently in a pull request, but in a really advanced state. It could be merged really soon, to be fair. And this gives us the perfect link we wanted between the ERP and the DMS. Also, now we have a problem because Odoo already has their attachments. So maybe we could think that the DMS files may overlap with Odoo attachments, but work in this topic is being made, and to be able to integrate both systems and make them perfect compatible. And for now, the DMS is only in English, but translation is just a matter of time, and we will probably translate it to Spanish as soon as possible. But well, I think that there is no better way than showing you what is the current state and how the document management system of the OCA is than showing it to you. So I will proceed with a very, very small demonstration about its main functionalities. Here I have a local Odoo 12 instance, where I have included the base module, and I have also included some of the advanced stage pull request in order to be able to show you in more detail the functionalities that will come soon. So basically, this is one of the main views of the DMS. Here we can see all our directories, and we can filter and access them through the search panel in the left that was backported from version 13. Here we can navigate and we can filter. And here we can also check with the tags and all other grouping tags that we can use to make our accessibility easier. And as soon as we get into one of the DMS directories, we can see all the information related to it. Here we can see all the subdirectories, all the files that it includes, meta information about when was this file created and who has worked with it, access information regarding which permissions do we have in this folder and the folders under it, groups which also tell which permission does each group has above this directory. And then here also another category, another basic information as the size of it and all of that. Here we can also access very easily to the subdirectories and the files that it has. Here with the subdirectories, we get these really nice views where we can navigate to data, and in data, we can check for the files. For example, here we get to the file model, which contains information about actual files. When we click in one of them, we can see its name, its path, its extension, also information about when it was updated and created, access information, and we can of course view the content. In case that the file is previewable, we can see it directly here, and we can also download it and access through other program in case the file is not compatible with that. So here I have showed you the two main models of the DMS, which correspond to the directories and the files. And it doesn't have any secret. It's just very easy to navigate and to add and remove and move documents from one folder to another, which is the core part of the DMS. Another key part I told in the previous minutes ago is that this DMS is perfectly integrated with the rest of the ERP and the records. So we are going to make an example about how can we link a directory or some files to a record. First of all, what we will have to do is to create a storage. A storage is a model that is above the directory model, which provides some more general information and characteristics about the document, the directories that will be under them. So the basic structure of this DMS is storage is above everything. Then under them we can find the directories, and under the directories we can find more subdirectories or files. Here we are going to create a storage, and we will make the demonstration with the contact model, the most the easiest one. So we are going to create the contact storage, and we are going to say that this storage is selectable by contacts. Okay. Now we will go to a contact, for example, Brandon Freeman. And here, of course, we will have to edit the view and give some space in a tab or somewhere in the form to the DMS widget. And in here, I have a demo example implemented in the REST partner. Here we can start with this button. We can link the record to a storage, as we said before. And now we can start playing. We have this really nice view integrated in the form with these buttons that will allow us to do some of the most basic stuff. We can begin creating some subdirectories. So subdirectory one, subdirectory two, for example. And here we can easily begin to create our structure. We can also right click in one directory to create more directories. So one. And here very easily we can begin to create the desired structure. We can also create files directly from here. And for example, we want to add a file under this folder. We can click this button and we can upload our file, for example, this C++ book. And here we have it. It's perfectly added to the tree and linked to the record. And here we can have information about it, and we can even preview it very easily from the record itself. It is also compatible with the drop feature, so we can also add, for example, this sale order. We can drop it here, and the sale order will be already linked to the DMS too. A new DMS file will be created. So, well, basically that is all. And now we could do the same, for example, with other records, no? Here, and we will add, for example, another directory. So now we have created in a couple of contacts, we have linked them to the corresponding directory, and we can see that we can very easily from here, from the contacts storage, we can access all the information regarding the partners. Here we have the folder we created from Brandon Friedman, along with the one we created with Colin Diaz, close next to another, so which makes it very, very, very easy to navigate. And that is basically it. I finally want to show you the portal made by Victor Martinez in Tecnativa, really nice way to navigate through the your documents too. Here you can download it, and that's basically it. So thank you for this amazing feature. Now back to the presentation. I think that I have showed you more or less which is the main idea of the DMS, the main modules and the main views. So now I would like to talk a little bit about the future of the DMS, which is the roadmap to follow. Actually, a missing key feature of the DMS is the versioning. Still, it's still not possible to manage the multiple versions with the DMS, but it is the first things, the first in the to-do list. So we will probably begin working on it soon. Also, we need to improve the attachment integration, translation to other languages. It's always nice. And now with the recent version 14 branch, it would be also great to have it migrated in the new version. And then obviously some other general improvements that can help make the DMS better. So that's it. Thank you to everyone for attending, and especially thanks for the OCA sponsor for making this event possible. And now, if you have any doubt or any question you want to ask me, pues feel free to talk or to ask on Discord later. Thank you very much.
Yeah, so anyone, participants, anyone has any questions, you can ask on Q&A so that I can convey to Jaime, and you can raise your hand so that I can unmute you if you want to speak.
There is no question. I would have one.
Okay.
I'm not sure. I haven't had a look too close look into the module myself, but it looks indeed very interesting. Are you aware of possibilities of storing the attachments in online repositories, online DAF servers, or something like that, instead of in the file system or in the database? Because the question is, you can store IR attachments on the file system or in the database usually, but does the DMS come with an abstraction layer that allows you to put the attachment somewhere else?
We are still on development, but yes, of course, it is on the to-do list to be able to extract all these attachments onto another server or another place that can handle better the information.
For instance, there are lots of modules on the App Store dealing with Nextcloud or SharePoint or whatever, and I think it could be an interesting feature to be able to store the file attachments and such offline off-site store.
Okay, so well, maybe we can add it to the roadmap and have in mind that it's I also agree that it's a very interesting suggestion. So we will try to work on it for sure.
Actually, there was a remark of Dennis Russell here. Saying that storage would be the way to go for it. Maybe Dennis can comment on this himself.
So Dennis, like, if you want to say something, you can raise your hand so that I can unmute you and you can speak. if you want. And there is also one more question from, okay, no issues, Dennis. So there's one more question from Henrik Norlin that, can we see PDF files directly in the browser, or do we need to download them?
And there are some kind of files that are previewable, for example, PDFs or some audio files that are previewable. There is a module in the social repository that is called Mail Preview Base, which serves as a base module to implement previsualizations for different kind of files. So if the file is previewable, it will be previewable in Odoo. But if it's not, if it's a code file, for example, you will have to download it and look for it in another program.
I hope, Henrik, that answers your question. So anyone else want to ask any questions? So I guess if anyone wants to ask any further questions, they can. Okay, so Henrik said that, what is the link to mail preview base repo?
It's on the OCA/social repository on GitHub. So you will be able to find it there, or I can send you a link on Discord.
Sure. So if there are any other questions from participants, you can ask your question on Discord. So Jaime will be able to help you there.
So I think we can leave it here, no?
I guess. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
I guess if there would be any other questions. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.